Praise the Lord so much. The Christmas season is here. And today I'm starting a new practice of sharing the lunch bite in video format for people who prefer watching more than just reading. And this day, the 14th of December, 2020, I'm indeed starting a series on the good news of a great joy. You know, the Christmas season is always a reminder of the best news that the world has ever received. Christmas season is a reminder of the best thing that has ever happened to the world. And that best thing is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And in this year, more than the other years, we really need some good news because the year has been difficult. Yesterday, somebody was saying that this year started off as 2020. But it is ending as 2020, you know? It started off with a lot of promise, a lot of expectations, great prophecies we have spoken over this year, but we've had a number of challenges. But in this season, I want to still say there is good news. Jesus is still good news. He's still the best news that has ever happened in the world, regardless of what we are experiencing, regardless of what we are going through. There is some good news. And I want to share with you a scripture in Luke chapter 2, verse 10 to 11. The Bible says, "But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which shall come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the town of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.'" Why was it good news of great joy? There's an army that appeared in heaven together with the angels. And that army is always available for you. That is the army that fights for us. That's the army that fights our battles. That's the army for which we are able to say we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. That army appeared in heaven, Luke chapter 2, verse 13 to 14. It says, "And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men.'" That is Luke chapter 2, verse 13 to 14. The birth of a Savior was a sign of God's goodwill towards men. It was a sign that God was reconciling himself to mankind. It was a sign of God's pleasure in men. It was a sign that God was thinking good things towards mankind, a sign that God was planning good things to us. I want to believe that the birth of Jesus was a fulfillment of Jeremiah 29, verse 11. "I alone know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to bring you disaster. Plans to give you a future and a hope." The birth of Jesus was a fulfillment of very many scriptures. One of them in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, that a king, a son is given, a child is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. The birth of Jesus was the fulfillment of Isaiah's prophecy that a Prince of Peace had come to the world. This is the Jesus that is written about in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, that how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and he went about doing good, and in particular, curing all who were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. This Jesus was born to do you good, to do me good. It's a celebration. This season is a celebration. But no matter how much we have gone through in 2020, there is still a Jesus who is willing to do us good, who is willing to save, who is willing to deliver, who is willing to be your friend. And the good news in the good news is that this Jesus is now available to live on the inside of every believer as the Holy Spirit. We shall talk more about this in the coming days. But for now, keep blessed, stay safe, stay strong, and stay in God. Remember, this season is about good news of a great joy. God bless you.